Oh, okay. I think now. Now it's working. What? It says offline now. Yeah. game here. Okay, is Flapsy going to join us for the review? Ah, okay. Okay, well, then we will just focus more on your moves, I guess. And hi.
Hello there, Dave.
Ooh, you're loud.
Oh, damn. It's only the built-in laptop mic.
Okay, so you were black? You were
I'm
black, yeah.
black here, yeah. Yeah, I play black, yeah.
Okay, so let me check. Everything seems to be okay right now. Yeah. That's the first time I stream anything that's on my browser, so just making sure I'm not streaming something random here. Okay. So let's see. I didn't look at it yet. Okay, double three three. Why not? Triple.
Why not indeed?
Okay, yeah, I mean, nothing wrong so far. Wait, what? Is that normal? That's strange, right? Yeah, that's
I
slightly.
thought DA team, sorry. I thought DA team the Joseki, no? Or is it different?
No, the 18 is fine, but I've never seen this one played right now. Weird. And here,
We're saying
yeah.
maybe black should do E18 instead, perhaps.
Yeah. I'm used to seeing white play here now because.
Yeah, I was expecting that, yeah.
Yeah, that's
That makes
normal.
sense, yeah.
But okay. Ooh. Okay. Anyway, that's the game. So here, yeah,
Let's wait for a wall.
it's a bit strange, but okay. I guess that's possible.
It has a ladder, doesn't it? You
Yeah.
don't play like Piazza.
But here, yeah, here white doesn't have to connect necessarily, I think.
Yeah, I thought he might Tanuki.
Yeah. Okay. But
What do you think about the
whoops.
result?
The end result I like certainly better for black
Mm.
because white has so many like if you look at that, white has those two stones which are basically doing nothing.
Yes.
So that's a way you can look at it. Just if you want to see the end result and want to get a feeling how good it is, just look at the efficiency of each stone, and you can see if you just remove those two stones, it doesn't look any bet worse for white, like at all.
Yes.
So that's why I didn't want to connect there as white, because it's just.
I see, yep.
If you just leave it like that and take center, then. Oh, whoops! Oh,
Yeah.
I'm only playing white. Then white doesn't even have to respond to this one. So, yeah, seems unnecessary. And against again here, I would even say I'd feel comfortable as black even playing Tinuki here, maybe.
Would you? Really?
Because if white plays here, black can just counterplay here, I guess.
What if white cuts?
Then you just play here.
And there's a ko, isn't there? If he plays A18.
Yeah, there's a ko, but
Yeah, a bit, I
it
feel it's a
it's
bit
it's
lucky, really.
it's so early. What is White going to play now? White has no ko threat yet, so
That's
yeah.
true, that's true.
But I mean, it's I don't see anything wrong with playing here. It's fine. It's good. No, I'm just saying it's a possibility, but I think it's also good just to play there.
I'm with you, yeah.
And
It's
yes,
kind of edge.
and
Yeah, go ahead.
yeah, and yes, at smoke view, fourth line and up means no third line opening stones. So if you have any suggestions, you can already write them in chat, and I will get to them later then when I'm done with the review. And hello. Oh, okay. So yeah, but all good here. Against this stone, the white stone is—it's a bit close to the black corner, so I would respond here for sure once.
Okay, I was talking to White about a couple of ideas. One about black F3, and the other one is black C5 there.
F3 is fine too. C5 seems a bit on the nose. It seems a bit like white. What's the follow-up here?
Well,
A
the
cut
idea
here?
was. Well, the idea I had was to go D4 and then make ko shape and then invade 3-3.
But it's not necessary to play a ko here. You're not gaining anything more than if you just play here. So it's yeah, it's.
Fair
It
enough.
makes sense if you don't compare it with better thieves, better moves. But okay, I mean, if you Tanuki, then you're essentially having invaded a 5-4 stone. So it's not like it's bad to Tanuki. It's just that, in general, I think d5 is a bit too close. So I would
Yeah, I guess.
respond and have it be a good exchange.
Fair enough. Right here, I was thinking about a couple of moves. Am I right to think that S6 is a bit more common for black here?
Yeah, a bit, but not much, I would say.
And white will do what here? Just make an extension on the bottom side?
Yeah, I as white would probably just play here, continue
Oh
here.
yeah, that makes sense. Yeah, that's natural.
Yeah. That's also why I would just respond on this side, because it kind of makes it too easy. Like, white is now starting to form something. So, and you have a pretty low position overall already, so that's why I
Am I
would,
right?
yeah, that's why I would consider keeping control of the center here.
Yeah, I'm with you.
Okay, I have to move chat
Yeah,
a bit.
another idea I had was when you get to black playing R4 and white playing this, yeah. What about jumping to R6?
Yeah, jumping to R6 is possible if you have a ladder. Talking about this one.
Ah, yes. I miss that you can just take the outside with the
Yeah.
ladder. Yeah.
But the ladder doesn't work for white, I think.
No?
No, it's running into J16.
Yeah, but isn't there E18 in here that you can play?
E18? No.
Yeah, like if he goes all the way up with the ladder, can't he then play E18 and then short some limiters? Maybe I'm just seeing things.
I think you're seeing things.
I'm still seeing things, I'm sorry. I'm very bad at ladders.
I mean, what E18 here? It's already running into J16, so.
Oh, J16, okay. I
Yeah.
thought it was going up to those three stones there.
No, not even that. So yeah, it's possible to play this run, and the advantage of this, and to understand why R6 is played, it used to be a bad move, but now it's just fine, I guess. And the idea is that if now white Tanukis, now you have this move, and this is slightly better shape for black than to have this and then play this one.
Ah, interesting,
Because
yes.
it puts a bit more pressure on the black on the white stones, because here white still has forcing moves like those.
Yeah.
But it's really minuscule, the difference, so I wouldn't worry about it. You can experiment with it if you want to, but I wouldn't
Well, I don't.
yeah, pay
Just
too much
putting
attention.
MQ5 playing against me in the first place.
And yeah. So what ha oh yeah, okay. Yeah, possible. Also possible. Yeah. All good. Locally speaking.
Good, good.
Globally. Okay.
Nice.
This one, I don't know. I would at least push once more here.
Do you
Just
think you should respond to
because after this move, the corner is in danger.
Oh, is it?
I think
I thought I'd be all right.
there's this move, and then there's moves like
Yeah, it's like E4.
that. I'm not quite sure, but the point is that white will get a lot of forcing moves there either way, so yeah.
It's going thick.
So yeah, at least I would play once more, and then you could think about that.
Okay. I played that like 50 moves later.
Yeah, just because if now white doesn't respond, you get the Hane at the head of three on both sides.
Yeah. I just thought that would be a bit too slow for me. I thought he'd probably take two, and then if I like, you know, if I push beneath those three stones, I'll just build it off the side, aren't I?
Yeah.
If he does say, you know, just E8, I push a bit. He just builds.
Yeah. So here, this one, you could also, I'm not sure if you even here have to invade. You could also think about this one. It's not as painful for white to get the Han at the head of four, because white still has five liberties, and five liberties is like, that's a border, you can say that's still okay. That's why you can let the
Yes.
opponent get the Han at the head of four, but it's still kind of forcing now for black, because white doesn't really want to ignore it one more time, I guess.
Was I follow up with P6 am I or what? Or if I Tanuki off the Hana?
If you were Tanuki, I guess you
If you
I
like play like C7 now, what would I do?
just ignoring locally, I would suggest just this one.
Okay, right.
Because now you're threatening really moves like O5, or attacking those four stones a lot harder while growing the right side. So there's no reason to leave more weaknesses here.
Okay, makes sense.
Yeah, I think I've tried black hole once, and someone played it against me, but yeah. But okay, split. Yeah, the issue with this split is that you're already pretty deep between two white groups.
I had a couple.
I think I would prefer at least high, maybe.
Yeah, I thought about going high, or maybe I can even play F5 prepare. But I thought if I
Yeah.
do F5 and he plays something like H4, then it's kind of like I'm just helping him, isn't it?
No, the peep is possible, but yeah, because you didn't play C7, it could be that white will just play something like that,
Yeah. It's just a probability, yeah.
and yeah, because you're not really interested in building a small base here in this area. You're more interested to keep flexible shape, and that's when you preferably play fourth line moves. Or maybe even higher. Maybe you can even consider playing fifth line move, because white won't play this one.
No.
So you can consider playing higher moves, or even reducing one more above that. So thinking more about reducing than invading, because and that's why I like this move more. you're thinking about reducing while growing your own still. It's not like white has an overwhelming amount of influence. It's more like both have one, well, you have more corners. So I would say that the situation, yeah, because of the top left, is certainly better for black here. I do like black better in this case.
Yeah, me too, actually.
Yeah, so let's see how this goes. Okay, that's good.
I was wondering, is it better to do this J4 or just a jump to M5?
Depends. I think this is fine.
Okay.
But this one. Typically, you would rather play here.
About
And
tables, you know.
yeah, but in this case, what you want is to keep more pressure on the white stones. So now, if white Tanuki is from the left side, you maybe have this cut, or at the very least, you have this Hane. And if white has to respond here, then you can just lightly go out here, something like that.
Oh yes.
And so, yeah, in that case, I guess, yeah, oh, whoa. Okay, that one. No, because white can now play this one.
I expected that, yeah.
And
So what do we
here the
do here?
question is, yeah, here the question is that probably this cut might work because here white has a wall close on the left side or has some stones, so could be dicey. So I would in this case probably play this one or just not exchange it at all if you're not sure there.
Okay,
Or
right.
you can also, well, the thing with this one is that maybe white can, well, probably not. Yeah, you can consider this one maybe. Something like that.
That's quite interesting.
So attach under first.
What about simply K4 near the star point?
Sorry?
What about just K4 as one? So the shoulders.
Here?
Yeah.
No. No, but that's for sure not good because this is creating heavy shape in his area.
How would he make me heavy here?
Well, just this one. Heavy in this case is all that's too close to each other without making shape, and black here doesn't make any shape. So this one
Okay.
would be of course be even worse.
Yeah.
But if you see this one instead, if you see this option, then you can already see that this is clean, this is much more forcing. And if white, for example, has to go here, you will still get more forcing moves here. And
Yes,
you can
yes.
still think about keeping this flexible also. But
Okay, yeah.
if you just play this, then you have no shape. You have created nothing but more problems, maybe. And also the option that maybe this is not even forcing enough and white just says, okay, I attack you as a whole.
Yes. Brutal.
Yeah, a buckhead was black there, Adam. So yeah, that's okay, yeah. Yeah. Fine. This one no. You want because this one gives him this Hane at the head of two shape-wise, and this one shape-wise I would certainly continue here, so possibly this extend or maybe maybe something like that.
Yeah, I was thinking about M6, yeah.
Yeah, so because this one is maybe this one, the problem with this one is you are forcing white into the direction of your weak group. Oh, okay, this one. Yeah, I would just play here as white and say you play this one.
Oh, the double hanoid.
Well, if you double Hane, then the problem here is that, well, the ladder doesn't work, okay, so it's still okay-ish. I guess it's fine, yeah. Might work.
Okay.
Yeah, but still, all these moves are pushing white even further towards your weak group. And since white has no weak group other than the right side group, at this point, I would say the weakest group on the board are A and B. And so, if you think about it like this, now you're forcing A to be stronger towards your B. And what? You can recognize I'm German? What? Mind blown. Anyway, so yeah, that's a bit passive by white here. So, and that too. Ooh, that's too good for black. Though I could, oops, I could see arguments for you to play either this one or maybe even this one again.
What about J6?
It's just that this move for white feels good.
Yeah, you can move
So,
it there, yeah.
yeah.
I don't want to let him have that.
So, why I'm thinking about this one is that even after this, there's still possible peeps here, and white's shape will just get ugly. And so this one is a bit not here, no there. White can still Hane here. White can still Hane here, kind of.
I was going to do M6 if you did that.
M6.
Yeah.
Are you sure? Don't you mean M5,
Oh
maybe?
no, I meant F5, I meant F5.
Yeah.
Take it back.
But here's still this. White could do this, maybe. Okay, you didn't respond to that, but yeah, your shape here is just strange.
Yes, it is that.
There is also like this one now, which is threatening to capture the two stones, and if you have to respond like this, then this is just sad.
Physical pain.
Yeah. So yeah, this one is a bit indecisive, I would say. It's just, yeah, and then this was my game move. Okay. Yeah, and here you can see the relation of those two stones is a broken shape.
Yes.
So, yeah, I don't like that for white black. Yeah, now you're breaking the shape even more. Now it's a real broken shape. Now it's a knight's move, a broken knight's move. So here for sure I would play this one, I think.
Okay, and just let the center be paying
Yeah.
stones, is that
And
right?
if white now plays something like this, then maybe you can just go out here or respond like that or something. This one, yeah, it just doesn't give you good shape, and now white gets more forcing moves here, and yeah, you have to see that you're not surrounded here, and then white gets even more forcing moves here. I would argue that maybe this one is a bit better for white because it's center against the two stones.
That's true,
Well,
yeah.
this one leaves a cutting point, but
I would get a
ooh.
housebreak in that variation.
Okay, black, white continues here. Ooh.
I wasn't sure if that was center
Yeah,
or not.
if you're not sure if this is center, then you should just protect your cut.
Yeah,
Or
yeah.
maybe this one. I don't know.
Sometimes if the game is going well, I end up sort of, trying to make it more exciting.
Yeah, because this one doesn't really feel like it's center. White can
Yeah.
probably just decide to fix the cut here, which is also big. And yeah, because the ladder works for white. And now here, I guess, yeah, white can just make life like that at the very least, and probably even better. Like this one is centered to connect
Yes.
and to break through white black's shape. It doesn't look maybe like It's Sente because might be some cutting issue here, but not really because of that. So, yeah. So this one seems a bit tastier, but I guess yeah, white responded. Like, this one, okay. Yeah, I still think you should just protect your cut here. And the advantage of this move is that next you're threatening this cut, which is also pretty big.
That's true, yeah.
So
That
the
makes sense to me.
K8 is first making sure that your weaknesses are fixed and then exploiting white's weaknesses. You could also see if there is a way to cut right away, but probably this is a bit too much. Yeah, I don't
That's a
like
bit
that.
too much.
Because I want to play one because it does create a pretty big bot top right side, but the cut at two is pretty nasty, and this move also, on the other hand, limits white on the left side. So
Yes.
even if now black gets this nice move, white gets this nice move, now everything is pretty much settled, but you got a pretty large corner on the right. Still can play c7 on the left, though it's not as forcing anymore, but it's still pretty big. And you still have more potential on the top side. So white doesn't really have anything other than some points around g2 and some points on the left. So
Yeah,
it's
I was
looking,
thinking
yeah.
that if I could just live in the center, if I could just live in the center respectably, then I would already have enough to win. So I play quite slowly it around the center groups, trying to make it very solid.
Yeah, the cut is just seems a bit painful, so
I just wanted him to fix the cut in Goto, you know? I can just get this after the game. He did, which is nice.
well, he had to.
Exactly.
But the thing is that now M9 is kind of close to thickness, if that makes sense.
Yes, it's surrounded by more life.
Yeah, so instead it would have been much nicer for you to have protected the K7 cut right away and not have these weaknesses here left. Because now you leave yourself kind of attackable here. And M9 is just a bit too loose and not doing anything. If M9 was still attacking something, then it would be okay. But because it's basically a stone very much near to a wall, if you want, it's a bit wasted. And this one doesn't really do
That's
that
not
much.
interesting.
Yeah, I mean after this one, black is so far ahead, I might still just connect here to be safe. Or play this one still. Because that's something I'm currently learning in my games, that when I'm ahead, then I'm pretty comfortably ahead, that I then make sure that I gain that I remain with center control, that I don't get attackable and
Yes,
giving the
yes.
opponent too much. So yeah. But in this case, I could also see black just playing something like that, some big moves on the top side. So yeah. If you're already aware that maybe white can gain some points in the middle by attacking, and you calculated that the top side is enough for you, even then it's okay to Tenogi. I just don't see
Thought
the
limiting
risk.
my abilities with that much.
This one, that's not
Yeah, it's just
that's unusual. Yeah, that's something that you don't usually play when it's so open on the board. You'd rather have a Hane here and utilize your R14 stone this way, or yeah, I would probably just Hane here, or maybe pull back with this one, or even this one, possibly, but maybe just this one, and then white doesn't have any more forcing moves, so.
I see what you mean, a move to R16. I was thinking if I do the Q16 hand now, he's played something like P17. If he just lives on the top side, it feels like I wasted my stones like J16 did.
No, because J16 was J16 was just for making a base. It's not for making points. It's for staying in control with this group. That's a key difference. So don't never think. So that's one of the most often make mistakes, I think, especially in queue games, but even beyond that, that you think of your base as points. But it's much more important to think of the base of a group as something that gives it strength and center control, which is what the which is what the opening and the middle game is all about. The points is basically yes, and especially with all this early 3-3 bonanza, I don't know. It's
Bonanza. Suppose you know that one, Russell.
it's a game, I don't know.
Where did you learn the word bonanza?
During church? No, I don't know. But anyway, the thing is that you the points will come naturally, and the early 3-3 might seem that grabbing points early, that's good, and then you care for the rest. But caring for the rest, that's what then becomes more difficult, of course. So you have to be able to. And the more important part is that you have to understand that the points in the game come naturally by, well, by exploiting weaknesses and by fixing your own, more or less. And of course, you have
Okay, you're back now. It's a bit quiet. A bit more needs to come up a bit. I actually have a volume control. Don't know why I'm asking you to do it. No. No, you're back now. It's fine. Dropped in the German wheat beer, eh? Yeah. Can hear you. I can hear you. You hear me, Twitch lads? You getting this mic?
How about now? Okay, now I'm getting a signal here at on my end.
Still hearing you?
Yeah, I think I have one USB port, which is a bit unstable, and I must have chosen that one.
Fair enough.
Okay, good. Anyway, so yeah, the focus on points is generally not good, and that's also where this greedy attitude comes from, that you think you have to protect yours, quote unquote. So it would be
Yes.
totally fine to let white live on top because white doesn't have much yet. Okay, it's suddenly loud, so should be good to go again. But yeah, if in any case, because yeah, you are just alive on the right side, you could also just play this and not give white any more forcing moves there. But of course, white can just play this. White can also later maybe get this one or get something like that. So anyway, that's why this one is, it's just a bit over. Oh, okay.
Live life.
He can just play here, and after this one,
I thought if you did it this way, you'd probably do R16.
No, wait, then you can just play here.
No, that's that he would do that as 3-4.
I'm not sure what you're.
I thought he would put his third move, the number 3, on R16.
Oh, no, you want to cut because then you have more forcing moves here. Like so.
He doesn't have that ladder unlocked. Or does he? Does he even have it?
Probably not, no. But then White could also choose this one, maybe, if the ladder doesn't work. Because this one for sure does work.
That looks quite nice for black.
Yeah. But no, what for black? Well.
Yeah, it looks alright for black, I think.
Yeah, but it could have been. You're giving up. Yeah.
Basically, if it jumped out, so
Your
I could have.
R14 stone is now isolated. That's my issue. I was thinking because yes, it still looks good for black, but that's just because the game looked that good for black before that.
Oh
So,
yeah, so
yeah.
he only won by half a point and then timed out. That's the scoring.
So,
I was thinking about Q18 there, parrying from the top.
P18?
No, I was thinking about black instead of Q16, kind of a tarry from
Ah, okay.
Q16. I like it, but I thought he connects and then let's play R18.
Yeah.
If I do say R18, he can just P16, and it seems like quite easy development for him. Something like that, yeah? I thought I said
I guess, yeah, but you still have N11 and you this group of white still is weak, so white for sure has to spend more moves. So if we look at it like this maybe,
Yes.
then there's still some RG left. You S16 for you is still sente anytime. It's possible, I would say.
Okay. All
But yeah, that all is the issue with your initial move then. So, yeah, okay. But I mean, I guess it worked out well for you in the end because also White messed up.
In the game, he played S17, but I thought he might play R15 more. So I played this, I played, and then he played S17, but I thought he might play
Possible,
R15.
but then Black can just play here, so. Yeah, I don't think that's a desirable
I guess so.
result.
Fair enough.
Yeah, so in the end, you got a really good result here.
What do you think of N11? Sorry, N12, sorry. Anno.
N12 makes sense. You are trying to cut off the way for White to come in there. And also strengthening your bottom group kind of a bit, but yeah, it's okay, I think. Okay, that's ooh, yeah. Yeah, so now White can still decide to ignore C7, so that's why I would do it right away. Now you get into a fight, a complicated fight. So yeah, here for sure again you have to be mindful of your cuts, and I would just play this run, for example. Yeah, or you can connect, but this one gives this a bit more stability, even though the shape is not is harassable, but I mean, yeah. Because yeah, that's your winning condition pretty much. If you just get all the top points and you don't die on the bottom side, then you win. So it's the safest way to just connect this, in my opinion. And
Finally, player C7.
yeah, huh? That one, huh? Maybe just here. Just keeping up the pressure on the white stones. Yeah, here. Whoops. Here it's a bit too. Ooh. I was just about to say it's a bit too easy, but now. Huh. Here you. Here what. What's the purpose of this move? Is it making points?
Well, the idea was that I make sort of landing point for playing G11 later, and I can start reducing his left side.
Okay, so the other way to think about it is to just play this, keep the three white stones weak, and while white has to run out, you just get some moves like this naturally while attacking.
Oh, of course, yes.
So after that, yeah, I mean it should still be good enough, but you see where you are starting to lose ground more and more, because J12 is not doing it's doing something but not very efficiently. Yeah, and then this one is pretty big, and then this one is overly passive now.
Yeah, I wonder about that. Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, what do you think is a good move for Black here? Maybe just start playing B some?
What's a good move here? Maybe block white here? But I'm not quite sure. Yeah, because here now white comes in and gives you a lot of trouble. So if you count here and you see wow, I'm really far ahead if I just take the top side, which I have the impression without counting, but it doesn't. I don't see points for white. Then I might consider just playing something like that. Because I do know that this formation does have RG, and
Yes.
there's still some kind of peep here, so you have some trouble here. So if you're far ahead and you know that, then all you have to do is just fix it, and you're done.
Yes,
No
yes.
risk, no risk. Maybe less fun, but especially less fun for your opponent, because now it's harder to win this game. So yeah.
Just to say, can we aim to wrap up at about 7 minutes time? Because we're on the hour. Is that
Yeah.
all right?
Yeah,
Okay.
yeah. I was about to say not much after this, but yeah, here
End game,
yeah.
I played a bad end game.
Yeah.
I mean, I always think I play a bad end game, so always think bad to me.
Yeah, you're and that's something in the end game you have to understand. It's more about the borders than the middle. So moves like this just don't do much.
I was thinking he could get Q13 for him to cut and then go down to R13 and get some points there. So if I just play like S8 now.
But maybe you can do it more forcefully with something like that,
Ah, yes.
if you are worried about this. But I see moves like this one, for example, are bigger. Or yeah. Maybe even just if you're worried about the right side, you can also think about moves like that, or yeah.
Oh yeah.
It does look pretty one-sided for black, so yeah. Yeah, you respond very. Here you didn't respond, but yeah, you can see white is continuously playing all the second line moves, which in endgame are bigger than middle moves.
Yes,
So
yes.
that's and then yeah, and then you can see why I wanted to play c2 for black.
Yeah, got the reduction and everything, yeah.
Yeah. And then white got all this and got some more here. Maybe you don't have to respond to that.
I just wanted to
To
do
this
that.
one. Yeah, so yeah. And then this one threatens to take two stones again. And white can choose which ones.
That's true.
What often players think, if white cuts here, I can just throw away those two stones, which were the least, but of course there's no connection here. I did get this shape against a one dan in my last tournament, so that was fun.
Yes.
I got to cut him apart. yeah, so you defended, but yeah, all in all, again, you okay? This is not center, so you wasted a move there, and white got a18, which is well not that big, but yeah. Anyway, let's wrap this up. But what was the score?
The score, oh, it's interesting that. I timed out with literally all the point moves just done. I was about to press score. We put it into a score estimator. It said, I think it said white plus 2.5, but we noticed it was giving white a couple of damage. It was giving white c1, and it was giving white r1. So we decided we would fill all the damage in, we would count it ourselves, and we came up with, I think, plus 1.5 for black with all the Pomian prisoners in.
Yeah, I mean you lost, you easily lost like 15 or more points in endgame, so that
Much as that, oof.
at least
When we did
bit
it at endgame, though, I was like.
probably more, because already this is pretty big for white.
Yeah,
Like
fair point.
if you compare this with black getting this and threatening to play something like e1 next, that endgame alone is almost what, 10 points? So 15 points is probably too low even. You were so far ahead, you should have been ahead by like 30 points at some point or something like
Just
that.
like that, it all happens.
Yeah. So I guess well, endgame is it's I don't advise practicing endgame too early, but just the basics of endgame, how big those second line moves are, especially that might be something worth looking at. And yeah, and overall, if you find yourself ahead, then thinking about fixing those cuts directly more here. So because moves like that can be superior, but more often than not they're just too cute. With KY.
So basically, the morals of the story are, fixed your cuts directly instead of faffing around. Look for second line moves in the end game. Is there anything else going?
And
Make sure you can threaten to hand on the head of 3 stone for this gem we sent out, like c7.
yeah, just it that's with experience, but just being aware of the strength and the weaknesses of your groups. I'm not sure when it's good to put the most focus on that, but I just know from my own experience I probably started that too late. And I'm not saying too late in a sense of now I can't fix it anymore, but I'm saying it in a sense of I would have progressed so much earlier if I had focused more on that earlier. I feel I did a lot of focusing just by start of last year, and I was pretty much stuck at one queue for over 2 years before that, so.
And that was from focusing more and more.
What?
That was from focusing more and more again.
I'm focusing. One of my main focuses is to look for weaknesses and strengths of groups on the board.
Yes.
And then to see the shift in dynamics when more stones are added on the board. So to see how effective stones get and how not effective. And
Yes, power, eh?
what forcing moves my opponent has, what attacks my opponent can have, and the other way around. So I had a game yesterday. No, wait, that was today. I had a game today where I was really far ahead and I had the option to take a greedy move or take a safe move, and I managed to take the safe moves. So that awareness, that's something I'm working on, and then just general positional judgment. So that's something
Yes.
I don't trust my own enough. So what I often end up doing, because that's what I've been doing the last year, is that I started playing more aggressive for sure, and now I have difficulties finding the off switch at the right time. And because I don't trust my positional judgment enough yet, that leads to me being too aggressive when I don't need to. Even when I counted that I'm ahead, I might risk more than I need to because because I didn't trust my judgment yet. So I'm working on filling a data an extra database there with positions where my positional judgment either was right, but I didn't act on it, or was wrong, and I should have acted differently. And that's two of my main databases. I have a database for endgame, though that hasn't been filled in a while, and I have a database of successes, so I can also see where I made progress and pat myself on the back and not only make myself miserable because I am not learning because I only make mistakes, you
Yes.
know? Yeah, and playing on a regular basis, of course, is and reviewing in general. Without that, I wouldn't even have the chance to see my mistakes and focus on that. So, I guess that's a given there.
Okay, well,
Yeah.
thanks for the review.
Yeah.